Ever thought about how strange it is that dogs will eat these dry, weird-smelling bits of food for their entire lives and never get sick of them? How torturous would it be to be forced to eat the same boring cheese sandwich for every meal of the day for a decade on end? Are we torturing our dogs? As it turns out, no. Dog food kibble is a chemically custom tailored product that meets every mark when it comes to nutrition, diet, and the interesting eating preferences of dogs. Once you see what dog food kibble is actually made of, you'll come to find that the real wonder science behind it is the chemistry used to tickle Sparky's fancy into thinking this stuff is to die for, when really, it's not. Making the perfect dog food kibble is a scientific puzzle because each bite needs to balance a lifetime of nutritional requirements with affordability and, of course, with palatability, though some dogs seem to eat just about anything. To optimize nutrition and cost, some added ingredients aren't exactly what dogs would want to call food, so scientists had to create a solution to trick their senses into thinking it's something that it's not. But before we get into that, let's take a look at what's inside of a pellet of kibble. An organization called the Association of American Feed Control Officials provide nutritional standards for dog food manufacturers. There's a whole bunch of different dog food formulas on the market. Some are designed for weight loss and others for richer coats, but the overall ingredients are relatively standard. These include grains, meats, fats, a vitamin-mineral premix, and chemical additives for color and a longer shelf life. Yeah, your dog probably eats a better balanced diet than you. Grains like wheat, rice, and corn are added as a source of starchy carbohydrates that offer an inexpensive source of energy for dogs. Since raw starch isn't easy to digest, the grains are cooked, which makes the starch in them about 90% more digestible. This allows dogs to extract more nutrients out of the grains, giving Sparky the energy boost he needs to play with his friends all day. Cooking the grains also gives kibble its shape and texture by causing the starches to gelatinize, giving kibble a stable, bulky quality. Some types of grain also provide fiber, which makes using these little bags a lot easier if you know what I mean. But when it comes to a dog's choice of what they prefer to eat, dogs will more often than not choose meat over carbs. Meats and meat meals are added as the primary source of protein in kibble. Meat meals are made from all the animal parts we typically don't eat, scraps, guts, and bones. These byproducts are cooked and dehydrated and end up contributing more protein to the dog food than added meats. Dogs will break down proteins in their small intestine into amino acids, which are crucial for muscle growth and synthesis of hormones and neurotransmitters. There are 10 essential amino acids that dogs need to survive, and all of those need to be included into a healthy dog food diet so little Fido can hug your bed for years to come. Fats are also an important source of energy in a dog's diet. Little Scruffy's skin and coat are greatly affected by fatty acids, and without the right ones, his hair can become dry, matted, and, well, scruffy, making him an aptly named dog. So dog food manufacturers add in several types of omega-6 and omega-3 fatty acids to make Sparkle's more apt name. Fats also add a little extra flavor, which is a big help, because a lack of flavor is kibble's biggest problem. Well, to a dog, anyway. These crunchy, dry pellets are super bland, odorless, and unattractive to dogs. Not only are they largely made from grains, a food that they would usually have nothing to do with, research has also shown that dried dog food has far less aroma than the wet stuff. A dog's nose is around 10,000 times more powerful than ours, and they rely heavily on the sense of smell to hunt and scavenge for food in nature. Keep in mind, flavor doesn't just describe what's happening on taste buds, it also factors in aroma, so a food without a smell to dogs is really unappetizing. This is where flavor chemists come in. They developed a custom-built chemical aroma called palatants that trick dogs into thinking these bland palates have big flavor. Palatants are sprayed onto the outside of dog food, similar to how we flavor potato chips. The big difference is that Sparky doesn't care for smoking hot barbecue. He wants rotten corpse or raging roadkill. Dogs are attracted to flavors that would make us gag, like putrescine and cadaverine, two cleverly named compounds that come from the breakdown of proteins. These two compounds quite literally smell like a dead body, and for some reason, dogs absolutely love it. Yeah, Max will be having the time of her life when that zombie apocalypse finally comes. Flavor chemists build palatants off this bizarre preference, which helps to give that bland, dried kibble a desirable disguise to stroke Sparky's interest. Keeping your dog happy is keeping your dog healthy. Flavor chemists use their genius to make these boring bits of food into something spectacular to your dog's nose, and we thank them for that. Oh, and believe me, they're on your side. When making these artificial dog aromas, they factor in our sense of smell too. So you know, we don't vomit every time we open the dog bag. If you're a music fan, which I'm guessing is most of you, you should definitely check out Soundfield, the newest show from PBS Digital Studios. Soundfield breaks down our favorite songs and artists from all genres, from Bach to Beyoncé. The show is hosted by two amazing musicians, Nari Soul and LA Bunker, who even come up with an original song in every episode. Check out Soundfield in the link in the doobly-doo below. We love making videos about pets and want to know if you have any other pet-related chemistry questions for us to answer. Let us know down in the comments and be sure to like and subscribe on your way out. Thanks for watching.